Anissa, and yeah, welcome back again to me. So today will be a little bit of my feedback evaluations regarding my 3 months teaching practice. So I'm in charge in Universitas Internasional Batam for my teaching practice as a lecturer assistant. So I teach several classes, which is I think several of you know me, and if you know me, you can say hi on the chat box below if there is a chat box. But anyway, to start with, what is my best and worst experience in teaching? So the best one that I see so far is the thing that when I assigned an activity to the students, and the students was doing the activity. So I have this one activity which I tell the students to write their own one sentence in this one application. Not application exactly, but like a website platform, which is, it is like a sticky notes, online sticky notes, which everyone can write their own sentences, and they write their own sentences, and then I ask them, since the class that I was teaching is really related to the inductive teaching method. But anyway, after that, it is really the best part, since we're having fun, we're loving and everything. And one of my best part is also the thing when they open their camera when they are having a presentation towards me. I think the first example is like the 2VUME class, and the last one is the 8GAMA, so it's like a public speaking class for me.
Okay.
Okay, Vic, go ahead.
Okay, yeah.
What is the, maybe Milan, if you are not busy, can you help your friends answering the words? I'm a pro in this. I can do it.
Hello.
Okay. Hello.
Hi.
Yes.
Milan, please help us.
Oh, read those difficult words.
Yes.
Yes, all of them.
Phenomenon, occasion, necessary,
rural. Procalifragilistic, exceptialidocious.
What the fuck is that?
Thank you, Milan. You're a pro in this.
So.
But it is really interesting, since I mean, this will be related to my worst experience in teaching, which is no one answer my call, or well, not no one, but sometimes they didn't answer the what I was talking about when I'm calling them.
Thank you, MC. Bye. We'll on your next class.
How I feel after 3 months? Wow, I feel amazing. I mean, like, you never know what. Well, you need to try if you want to know what it is feeling. But for me myself, it is really an interesting experience, particularly, which is, I didn't know if this is like a should try or you can add it up on your sticky notes to the list or everything like that. But for me, this is really interesting because I see a lot of new perspective of the students. I see a lot of perspectives from the lecturers. When I start the class, I felt really nervous, of course. I mean, like, I never, instead of me, I'm the one with the weakest teaching experience than my classmates. My classmates have their time focusing on what is teaching, how you need to teaching, what is the good things on teaching, what you can do when you want to approach your students. But anyway, I didn't have, I mean, like, if we are talking about that, I felt really nervous, my anxiety growing up, I felt like I cannot do the classroom management and everything like that. I mean, like, I felt like this is a failure for me to be a teacher when I didn't know even a single steps of teaching, which is making me really want to cry at the first day. But after I finish it, I think I want to try again. This is like when you say hello and then you have a farewell after that, which is really sad actually, but I hope that I can continue on teaching. I mean, like, that's my dream. I think the first meeting that I was doing, it is like the silent way for the students, and then I'm change it to an inductive approach, which is really much more effective. If I can say that, am I being a better person after I teach? Or like, are there any behavior or any attitudes that, or any point of view that adds up to me? I would say yes, because I kind of know how it feels to be a lecturer when you're students are having difficulties, or sometimes the students are really annoyed you that you are feeling like, why these students didn't want to listen to you and everything like that, which is I kind of understand now. And I also, after I really are looking at the operating system of the learning management system in UIB, I got a better knowledge in making the questions, which is like multiple choices and everything like that, the true false one, and making the dashboard of the material itself. So every time I teach, I always think like, what can I do for the next meeting? And like, what if the next meeting I didn't do anything? But it's so funny when I overcome this kind of thing with making a note, and then I was talking to my mom.
Okay. Tulis sticky notes-nya gak usah tulis benar, tapi tulis nama aja. Melvin, atau ini, atau isi itu. Why did you want to move the bear? Oh my god. Okay, keep on going. Silakan buat sticky notes.
But sometimes when when I was teaching this, everyone will be asking like, are you convinced to be a teacher? I always answer that I'm not want to be a teacher, but I want to be a lecturer. But being a teacher is not bad also, I think. But the thing that I want to say is that I want to be a teacher in a higher education. But to add up, my journey in teaching experience is much more related that you need a resilience over this. Why? Because the first time that I want to teach, one of my lecturers said that my teaching is a no, a big no, with a serious face, and I was smiling over there over nothing, and it hurts. I'm like, it pained me, and that's why I didn't want to give up. And suddenly, three people come up to me, they want to be tutored by me, and that's merely not a coincidence, because I really are shocked that they want to be tutored by me. So two of the three people were want to learn English for the TOEIC official. Of course I didn't want to accept that. I mean like, it's really scary, you know. Everyone, I mean like, after getting a big pro, like, that's a big no. And I was feeling like, I think I cannot do that. I cannot guarantee that they can get a good score. But in the end of the lesson, she got from the first score that she tried, which is 500 in TOEIC official, she got 800. And I was really, of course, I'm crying over there. Like, are you kidding me? Because I still cannot believe that she's the girl that I taught. I mean, like, I teach her, and she got that. I feel like really are grateful for that. That's why I said that. Never give up on what you want to achieve. But anyway, that's about my experience. I hope that you have fun in my experience. Also, I don't know, but thank you for listening, and if you want to listen to this content, don't forget to.